Hey Soul Fam, Amelia D here. Hope you guys are feeling good and doing good. I'm feeling good. I'm doing good. Let me scooch you up. I got a quick message for you today. Yes, I'm in the part transition, guys, of putting Blondie back together. So we're going to band do it until we do it. Okay? Okay, so Soul Fam, I know it's been a couple days and I know I haven't been posting like I usually post, like every 2 days or 3 days, but that's because I don't want to oversaturate this message. And the message is very clear and the message is straight to the point that we have to not be distracted around this time. You know, it's easy for us to kind of indulge in our distractions, and sometimes we're so indulged in them that we don't even know that they're distractions. So that goes for me too. Okay, so not to say that coaching is a distraction, but meaning I have to be able to focus. You know, I gotta be able to make decisions. If I'm focused on 20 million things, how could I make decisions? And I know I got 20 million things always going on. So sometimes you gotta slow one thing down so you can clear up that space in your mind so that you can think clearly, think logically. So, you know, I practice what I preach. That's number one, okay? So take this time, Soul Fam, to quiet down some of the noise around you, because you aren't gonna really get what you're looking for if you're looking in the wrong directions. Okay? And no, coaching is not the wrong direction for me. This is the right direction. That's why I'm popping in here. But I ain't talking about me. Okay? For you, Soul Fam, quiet down some of the noise. Okay? Speak to the right people. Sometimes we so distracted with things that don't have substance that we're pouring out our life into people that don't even care about our life. So it's important that we stick to what is for us. And sometimes we be trying to force things that are not for us. Some people are not for us. Some environments are not for us. And even some jobs are not for us. And we're constantly trying to force it because we think this is the amount of money we need for this and that and this and that. And oftentimes we lie to ourselves. You can get a paycheck anywhere. Let's be honest. You could get a paycheck anywhere. It's about knowing what you want to spend your time on for getting that paycheck. And when you're not focusing and you just kind of reacting and you don't take time to silence the room, you're going to make an irrational decision. You're going to be sitting around working twice as hard as you need to work. You're not going to get the right clear ideas that's for you. When things go wrong and things go sideways and things go from what we're not expecting, our natural reaction is to, okay, what could we get quick? What could we do quick? You start kind of getting flustered and then you start making an irrational decision. Like, that decision that you're making isn't logical because you're not in a logical state of mind. So how can you make a logical decision? You hear what I'm saying? And same about getting advice from other people. Sometimes we go in and we pouring out to others and we expect others to kind of like help us and guide us. And we taking advice from someone who don't bear fruit. We taking advice for someone who's always complaining. We taking advice from someone who don't really think. You can kind of tell how someone thinks by the things that they're doing. And we overlook this. We constantly overlook this. And we're constantly just acting robotically. We're just going with the flow. Who thought that was okay? Whose idea was it? Just go with the flow. No, I'm not going with the flow. I'm asking questions. Because whoever's going with the flow could flow down a dead stream. And I'm not trying to go down a dead stream. So fam, what I'm saying is take some time and spend it with yourself. And think for yourself. And think logically and clear your mind and see what's there. See what pain keeps coming up. See who keeps triggering that pain. Sometimes we sitting around triggers thinking we good because we had a session or two. You good for now, but if you keep playing around and laying around triggers, you're not going to be okay. You're playing with your mental health. You haven't built it up enough to notice when someone is a trigger, and you haven't even built up the strength to say the word no. Some of us think we healed and we still saying yes to everything. We still feeling bad about saying no. Yes, I'm guilty. And I've learned the hard way that, baby, it's okay to say no. It's okay to not always be available. For the ones that's always expecting you to be available. Because sometimes you got to say no so that you could get out of the way. Sometimes you the one that's always saying yes and always helpful and always there. You're making it harder for that person to move in their life. Because you're in the way. Thinking you helping. So fam, think about this change that's coming in 2022. Think about these goals that you're headed for. Think about these decisions you're making. Think about your choices that you have. And sometimes we have more choices than we think. You know? Sometimes we think, all right, it's either A or B. No. You only looking at A and B. Some of us are only looking at A and B. You got C and D. So you better sit around and map out these choices. This ain't no pepperoni or sausage choice. Like that. This ain't no pepper or sausage choice. Okay, Lord. No. It's easy for us to say pepperoni sausage. They both pork. It's not a hard decision. So fam, seriously, look at the choices your life has and make a logical decision. Okay? Think hard. Not too hard. Meaning, take a couple days to think. Sometimes we think we just need to think for 1 minute. No, babe. I need 72 hours to think. Okay? Because I have to be able to logically map through all of my decisions. And if I have about 4 decisions, I can't logically think about all that in 5 seconds. I have to think about the pros, the cons. I have to think about the risks. I have to think about the let go. I have to think about the return. These are things that you should be thinking about. Okay, well, if I do this, right, what will be my result? And you have to do that for choice A, B, C, and D, okay? And as you're thinking about it, take your ego out. Your ego gonna adapt to either one. But they be trying to run the game. Like, well, if you do this, you can look good. You can look that. You can have this. No, that's not a logical decision. If you're thinking on those terms, you're thinking too small. Because you're thinking about the things that don't really matter. You know, you're thinking about little perks, but the perks of this and that, this shouldn't be the core of your decision. The core of your decision is your mental health, your goals, your finances. Those are things that are core. And if you have children, but if you're not married, sorry. Mary had a little lamb. Okay, got to go. Because what are you gaining? Some of us are in these long-term 10-year relationships. Where is it going? Where are we going? Because I gave you 10 years. 365 days times 10. I gave you 365,000 days, if I'm calculating right. Don't mark me on that. But that's a lot of days, either way. Okay? It takes you 3 days to make a decision. If it's taking you 365 days times 10 years, you don't know how to make up your mind. So I'm going to make it for you. It's time to take control of your life. Some of us have no control of our life. We let little things and distractions control us. And because we get up every day, we think we in control. The only thing you in control of, baby, is that alarm clock. Because when it go off, you go back, you go right into work mode. Ooh, ooh, get dressed, work, gotta make this money. You're not controlling yourself. Definitely if you've been there for too long and you still have the same goals. See, some of us could stay in a place for a long time, but are goals being met? If goals are being met, oh baby, keep it going. But if you still recycling them same three goals, pay off this bill, pay off that bill, pay off that bill, pay off that bill, pay off that bill, you going in a circle. You're not elevating. You're rotating. Some of us are sitting around rotating and thinking we're elevating. So stop rotating in 2022. Get off the Ferris wheel. Okay? And it's easier said than done. Because unlike a Ferris wheel, you know, it just stops and you just get off. This life. So you need to take a moment and stop and get off of those, how would you call them? Get off of those highs, okay? We're gonna call them highs, right? Because when you do them, you get a little, you know, you get a little sense of satisfaction. You get an instant gratification. Like shopping online, order has been placed. You know, you get a little high. You're like, woo, I placed my order. You're scrolling on your phone. Dopamine. So you get high from scrolling on your phone, you know? Pull back. When you start to pull back, your body gonna start to fight. Like, wait, I need my dopamine. Wait, I need my coffee at 10 a.m. Wait, I need, you know what I'm saying? I need some toxicity. Wait, you know, your body's gonna start to fight with you. And this is where you gotta start using your head. You have to realize, okay, let me think logically about this. Let me clear up some time and spend it on me. Instead of going out on a weekend and being distracted, watching other people drink while you drink, instead of doing that, trust me, guilty. Instead of doing that, let's pull out a book, a notebook, and write out some real goals now. We done played around and we done tested things out and we did this and did that and we saw this and we saw what we needed to see. Now it's time to do what you need to do. Enough talking about it. I'm tired of hearing it. I don't want to hear it. Zip the lips. Okay. You can't talk and think at the... Well, you can't talk and think at the same time. But you know what I'm trying to say. You can't talk and listen at the same time. So how can you listen to your thoughts if you're just talking? Shh. Here. Internally. What do I need to do? For real. Some of us need to book us a therapy session. Some of us need to book us a coaching session. Because we sitting around trying to make new goals, talking to the same people that ain't trying to make new goals. Now, if you're the same people making goals, that's different. But if they ain't making no goals, what we talking about, Willis? What's the 411? You sound like a nice distraction to me. You gotta be able to witness when the distraction is right in your face. Not that it's a bad thing, but tread lightly. Because if you trip up and fall into that distraction deep enough, you're gonna be calling Jesus to get you out. And that's working harder, not smarter. Okay? Some of us don't even know what that means. Because we over here working twice as hard than we need to work. I'm gonna watch this video twice. Give me chills. Like, all right, Lord, you talking to me? Let me sit up. So fair. Let's take back our life for real. We played around and we did a little coo-coo-coo. We did a little, let me see what's going on. But now it's time to really get the game on for you. You have so much in you, so much potential, so much growth. And it's like, you don't even see that you the one holding yourself back. Because you're so afraid. You're so wrapped in your emotions. You're so distracted. Don't let the distractions take over you. Have more power. Have more strength. Have more wisdom. Have more discernment. Make it make sense. And if it don't make sense, dead it. Dead it. All right, so fam, I'm gonna go. Cause if I go a little further, I'm gonna say a little too much. And the Lord say, cut to the chase. Get the message out there. And all right. And don't be afraid to send me an email. Don't be afraid to book you a session either. I love to talk it out. Let's talk it out. Sometimes you gotta talk it out so you can hear it out. Sometimes we don't talk it out and we go in little circles because we don't really hear what's going on and we forgetting what we thought and it just gets confusing. So don't confuse yourself. Take some time and write it, read it, say it out loud, and hear what you need to hear. Because the answers are right in front of you, but sometimes we just can't see them because we ain't looking. We ain't looking. We look everywhere else. We look all around town, but what's right in front of us. All right, so fam. Amelia Adair here. Thank you guys for tuning in. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next win. Bye for now.